simply the best choice on TV. HBO.
Coming up next, a special report on the King of Australia, Tony Abbott. But first, let's watch every 90s kid's favorite hip TV program, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling, all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air living like? This might be alright." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said freshen it a dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it. Yo, home's the Bel-Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.
Hey, that's cool.